Hi friends, in this video I am going to explain you the topic searching in the arrays. There are two types of searching, one is linear, another is binary. Searching linear and binary. Linear searching is also called sequential searching. Sequential searching means you have to search a value in the array sequentially, one by one. If value is present in the array, then you have to display its index. The value is present at this index. If value is not present, which we are going to search, then there should be a message, value does not exist or not found. So here I have taken some values in the array directly. This is called dynamic or direct initialization of the values. 25, 10 up to 45, index is from 0 to 9. I am making here function void search, and you have to search this value n, and you have to search within the array. So question is this: if value is present in the array, you have to display the index of the value. If value is not present, then there should be a message, value does not exist. So we will make a loop from 0 to length. I am making a loop here for int I equal to 0, I is less than a dot length I plus plus, and compare the value of n with the value of arrays one by one. If it is present, then what you have to do? Take one variable, flag variable we can say, to store the index. Initially I have taken pos equal to minus 1, because if value does not exist in the whole list of the array, then pos, value of pos will remain minus 1. If the value is present, then pos will be initialized with that index. So within this loop, if value is present, then initialize or change the value of pos with I and terminate the loop. Out of the loop, here after the loop, you can check the value of pos. If pos equal to minus 1, system dot out dot print the message found at index, whatever the index is which is present in the pos, else print the message not found or does not exist. Close the search function and make the public static void main function. Main string arguments, create the object of the class name I have taken searching object equal to new searching, and call the function ob.search and pass any value. I am calling the function search here, search, and pass any value. Suppose I am passing here 30, and closing the function and then class. Try to understand the working of this program. Suppose we have to search the value 30 in the search function. So n will be initialized with 30. Start the loop. First we'll check the value of n 30 with the first value a0, which is not equal. Go for the next iteration. Next time n will be compared with 10. Then next time n, value of n is 30. 30 will be compared with 20, then 30 with 40, then 30 with 8, 30 with 12, and 30 with 30. Here the value is present. Pos will be initialized with its index I 6. Pos will become 6. Terminate the loop, and here pos is now not minus 1, it is 6. So if pos is not minus 1, so what we have to write? If if pos not equal to minus 1, print found at pos. Now right now pos is not minus 1, so it will print found at 6. Another example, if it is not 30, if it is suppose 31, again 31 will be compared with all the values of the array using this loop, and 31 is not present in this list,
So out of the loop, the value of pause will remain minus 1. So else block will execute and print not found. So this is the function. Now same program we can make with the help of return statement. Return statement means we will make is this function in such a way it will return minus 1 if value does not exist. Otherwise, if value is present, it will return the index of the value. So I am going to make the same program with in a different way. Just first of all, changing the prototype of the function, I am taking it int, and now there is no need of pause variable. I am removing everything. If n equal to ai, just write return I, the index if present, and after the loop return minus 1 and make the public static void main function. Create the object of the class searching. And call the function ob.search and pass the value 30. Suppose 30 is the value. Now this time you need to take one variable like k equal to this, because this function will return a value. So that returned value will be stored in the variable k. Try to understand, 30 is passed here. So 30 will be compared with all the values of the array one by one. When it is matched, it will return the index 6. So once it is returned, the function will be terminated, and the returned value of I will be stored in k. Here we can check if k equal to minus 1, print not found, else print the message found at k. K is having the index of the matched value. So suppose I am passing here 31. So 31 will be searched in whole array, which is 31 is not present, so not equal to any values. So loop will be completed fully. It will be completed after the loop. It will return minus 1. So if value is not present, it will return minus 1, and this statement will be printed. So this is the different ways to use linear searching. Now next is binary searching. In the next video class, I will discuss about the binary searching. That's all.